let us look into the question. A student wants to project the image of a candle flame on a screen 60 centimeters in front of a mirror by keeping the flame at a distance of 15 centimeters from its pole. Write the type of mirror he should use. Find the linear magnification of the image produced. What is the distance between the object and its image? And also, draw a ray diagram to show the image formation in this case. What sort of mirror should the boy use? He should use a concave mirror. Why? Because the concave mirror will form an image which is real and it will be on the same side of the object. Right? So the mirror is concave. So what was the second question? Find the linear magnification of the given object. For that, we need to write down V and U, right? So let us look into it. So to find the magnification, we need to write down V and U, right? So what is U? U is the object distance, which is minus 15 centimeters, right? Because he is placing the candle at 15 centimeters from the mirror. And he wants to project it at 60 centimeter from the mirror. So we have U is equal to minus 15 and V is equal to minus 60 centimeter. And now what is the formula for magnification? Magnification M is given by minus V by U. Right? So we write down the values, minus of V is minus 60 and U is minus 15. So solving, what do we get? We get minus 4. So the magnification is minus 4. Now we have got magnification M is equal to minus 4, right? So what does that imply? It implies that the image that is formed is real. And where is this image formed? It is formed at 45 centimeters away from the object. Okay, children? Now let us look into the next question. C. What was it? That we have answered already. They have asked us to find out the distance between the image and the object. As I said earlier, it is 45 centimeters. Why? Because the object is placed at 15 centimeters and it is projected at 60 centimeters. So 60 minus 15 will give you 45, right? Now we have to draw the ray diagram. Now let us see how the ray diagram looks. Now they have asked us to draw the ray diagram, right? So this is the concave mirror, right? So the concave mirror, the object is placed PQ between the center of the curvature and the focus. These are the lines that are reflected from the mirror and the image is formed at P dash Q dash, which is beyond the center of the curvature. Okay, children? So this is how you answer the question. Let us get into the next question. If the image formed by a mirror for all positions of the object placed in front of it is always erect and diminished, what type of mirror is it? Draw a ray diagram to justify your answer. Where and why do we generally use this type of mirrors? So, the answer to this question is, the image should be actually erect and also diminished, right? So, where do we find such image? We find it in convex mirrors, right? Where do we usually find these convex mirrors? We see these convex mirrors as rear view mirrors in vehicles. Why? Because, as I said, the image is erect and diminished. Hence, helping the driver to have the larger view of the traffic behind the vehicle. Okay. To justify this, they have asked us to draw the ray diagram. Let us do that. So, this is the ray diagram for a convex lens. The image always is diminished. AB is the object, A dash B dash is the image formed, which is real and diminished and also erect. Okay, children.